Hi, welcome to my intermediate home bodybuilding workout. This is an awesome workout you can do at home for gaining mass and strength. Now, this intermediate workout is broken into three separate workouts: a push workout, a pull workout, and a legs workout. The fourth day is rest. Now, this particular workout is the pull workout, and it is going to work your lats and your biceps. Now, if you haven't done my beginning workout for at least 2 months, or you can't do three pull-ups, then please stick to my beginning workout, because this workout won't do you any good. You're not strong enough yet. So, let's get started. This is five exercises. You're gonna do three sets of each exercise with 1 to 2 minutes between. I'm gonna cover how to do each of these. And I'll give you explanation about how to do the exercise, but if you have questions on any of these individual exercises, up in the corner of the picture, there'll be a picture-in-picture you can click on to watch a full video that explains how to do that particular exercise. So, let's get started with everyone's favorite, the overhand pull-up. Now, what you're gonna need to do this workout, obviously a pull-up bar. If you don't have one, get a doorway mount. You've got to have one. Or watch my video, 100 Places to Do Pull-Ups. You're also going to need a chair. Other than that, you're set. So, first exercise is overhand pull-ups, palms facing away from you. Now, you probably can only do one or two, maybe three of these. And the goal is to do 6 to 12 reps. Now, obviously, you're gonna need some help on the last rep. So here's what we're gonna do. So you're gonna do your pull-ups. You do as many as you can with good form. Bar in front of the face. Okay, I can't do anymore. Then you grab your chair and you're gonna do negatives here. So you push yourself up and lower yourself down. So that's a fourth rep, fifth rep, pushing yourself up, sixth rep. So do this until you get really, really tired, somewhere between 6 and 12 reps. And then you rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your second set. Rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your third set. Let me cover a bit the proper form of the pull-up. Palms away, remember I said that's a pull-up. Very important. The bar is in front of your face. You're not doing behind the neck. That's really bad on your shoulders, and you do not want a shoulder injury. The other thing, when you go down, so you're doing your pull-up. When you go down, stop when your arms are straight but not locked. Don't go to a full hang where your shoulders go up to your ears. Keep your shoulders down and back when you're doing the pull-ups. So, like that. Okay, so you've done the first exercise. The next exercise for lats is the barbell row. Okay. I lied, you do need a set of weights to do this. Now, you can do this with a straight bar or an easy curl bar, whatever you have. And bent over row, so you bend over, and you're going to row to your hips, like this, with the palms facing away from you. So, 6 to 12 reps. Oh, that feels good. Rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your second set. Rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your third set. So, we've done two great exercises for lats. Now let's do the third, which is actually a combination. This exercise is both lats and biceps. It's the chin-up with our palms facing our face. Again, we're gonna aim for 6 to 12 reps. So if you can only do a fraction of that, then we're going to use the chair to do the forced reps to get you up in the 6 to 12 range. So as an example, so I'm going to do, there's my chin up, one. Let's say I can only do three. Okay, then I grab the chair or have it in position, push myself up, lower myself down as slowly as I can. Push myself up, lower myself slowly as I can. Okay, I have my six reps. So rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your second set. Rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your third set. Okay, what are we doing now? Biceps. We're gonna do two exercises for biceps. Let's start with dumbbell curls. Now, most people know what this exercise is, but a lot of people do it wrong. Let me show you from the side so you can see. The proper form is like this. I'm doing them both at the same time, and you'll notice when I do this, my elbow is pinned right at my side, like that. The mistake a lot of people make is they do this. That kind of looks like the same thing, but it's all shoulder. Your elbow is not bending at all. It's exercising your shoulder, not your bicep. So, again, I'm gonna do. So do 6 to 12 reps of that. Rest 1 to 2 minutes. Do your second set. Rest 1 to 2 minutes, do your third set. Now, for the last exercise, the fifth exercise for biceps, it's hammer curls. Now, most people are not quite as strong in the hammer curls because it's going to work out a bit of forearm, too. The hammer curl, so the basic curl we just did is with the palms facing up. Hammer curl, turn 90 degrees so the thumbs are up. So it's exactly the same form, except the thumbs are up. And you're gonna get a great pump from this. So do 6 to 12 reps. Again, rest 1 to 2 minutes. Do the second set, rest 1 to 2 minutes, do the third set. On both the curls, one last form item you have to be careful. Again, you're doing them both at the same time. The reason is, when people do them one at a time, they tend to do a swingy thing. If you do them at the same time, it's a little harder to swing. Also, no bouncing with the knees. It's not doing any good for your arms if you're doing that. So, no bouncing with the knees. So, that was our five exercises. Are you done? No. Get out there and do 20 minutes of jogging. In the intermediate workout, you're doing at least 20 minutes of cardio every single day. Very important. That's it for this video, the pull workout of my intermediate home workout. Thanks for watching.